our focus. Today we are so honored to have Professor Maurizio Moretti to be our guest in our channel. Professor Moretti is a professor in Scuola Cantorum in Paris, and he travels so many countries and have concerts. And last week he was in Macau, and now we're in Vienna, and tomorrow he will go to Sweden. So it is a very, very busy and famous pianist. And welcome.
Thank you.
So let's start off with the first question. Could you tell us a little bit about your personal story as a musician?
Well, it's a long story, because today I'm 53 years old. But, well, I can tell you something very interesting. I start to learn piano because my brother, that is a doctor, start to get any lessons of piano. So I was looking at him about these very interesting things, you know. I'm very young, and I said, why not? I must do the same. So I try very early, about 9 years old. And then I went to the conservatory in Italy, conservatorio in Cagliari, my hometown, in Sardinia. And I followed all the lessons of my teacher. But then, after five, six years, I realized that it was not enough to follow only my teacher. That it was very good also, by the way, in the conservatory. But I tried to visit some other professor around the world. So I start to realize that probably I can do that in my life.
Yeah.
And so I participate in many competitions. So it was, what I can say, very natural stuff. So not so difficult for me to understand what I'm doing. So I just follow my passion. Just follow my passion. And of course, in the last 32 years of career, I played many, many concerts, and finally I realized my dream. That's my dream. But one of the professors more important for me was Aldo Ciccolini in Paris.
Uh-huh.
He's a great teacher.
Yes, yeah. So you have studied with the maestro Aldo Ciccolini for 5 years.
Yes.
Could you share some of his best advice that you have learned from him?
Well, Aldo Ciccolini passed away 2 years ago, and it's one of the most famous pianists in Europe, not in the world, and is also a really, he was an outstanding teacher. What he means outstanding teacher? It means that in his class, in the moment where he was in his class, it was a kind of a connection of a generation of young pianists all together. It was very lucky moment.
Mm-hmm.
And he was so nice to grow up all these young pianists in different ways.
Mm-hmm.
Respect the talent, respect the natural idea of the music of each one. And he was a great master of French music. It means Debussy, Ravel, Messiaen, Dupierre, Évody Poulenc. And we played in this class a lot of this repertoire, but also all the Donne Sonata, Liszt, complete works. So it was a great moment for me, but what this was very interesting for me is to understand how to do the career. And one of the most important things from his lessons is try to get all the time the right sound on the keyboard. So your style, your sound, your personal vision, not just a copy or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Just to be very correct, strictly correct in front of the score, in front of the composer, but in the same moment try to find your way, your style, your sound. He always say me, don't forget that sound is the communication between you and the audience. So that's very important. Well, I can say you many, many nice stories with him, of course. But I was playing the Ravel concerto from the left hand with him, It was very funny. I forgot the score for orchestra. And he was sitting in the second piano during the lesson. He said, don't worry, I can play the orchestra, but don't worry.
Wow.
So that's how she played. So competition is one way, but not the only way to grow up or to promote himself. I mean, of course, when I was younger, one of the ways was to have a kind of auditions with the artistic director of a festival and the orchestra, or with conductors. So I tried to make it personal audition then to show what I can do, what I can play. And it was a successful way because, of course, they understand it's more personal audition. Mm-hmm. Because the artistic director say, oh, this guy can play new things, so I take his name for the future. And I remember one time, one of the best things in my life when I started a career promoting myself, it was that I just finished a meeting with this artistic director in the south of Spain, in a big festival in Sevilla. And I received a call in a week from the same guy who said, can you play Beethoven concert number 4 in a week? I said, oh, wow, in a week. Yes, I know the piano concert. Yes, because some famous pianists canceled the concert.
Yeah,
so can you replace it?
Yeah.
And I was prepared to do one week before they were already, so we're already done, of course. Mm-hmm. But just to refresh the piece. And I got to play in Sevilla festival with the private Philharmonic Orchestra. It was great. So it depends. Competition from one side, private audition with the different artistic director or conductor in the concert society from the orchestra. And of course, be smart. What it means, be smart, it means to be ready to understand immediately which way we must go. For example, we are in Vienna now.
there are many, many persons around the competition, many, many situations. What is very important to understand immediately, very clearly, which person could be more helpful, which person is the most powerful in the middle of the group, and try to promote in this way. So don't lose time with everybody, but just to feel immediately what's that. That's also a good way.
Can you say a concept? What do you mean by a concept? A conductor? What do you mean?
I mean conductor of the orchestra. So, for example, if you met somebody as a conductor, he can suggest you as soloist. In a concert tour or in something special, that's very important.
And how do you usually do on a concert day, like before your performance?
That's a nice question. Thank you very much for your question. It's very interesting because in a concert day, it's not necessary to practice all the day.
Yeah.
I mean, for me, I don't need it. I need to be relaxed. Be inspired. So what I do every time is to work around, and I like it very much because it relaxes my body completely. And I have rules. I never go to the theater or stage in the morning. I just go 2 hours before. 2 hours before a concert is enough. Because if you go in the morning, that's, I'm speaking about my experience, of course, you get positive things, but also negative things. So I prefer to refresh a bit my mind, and 2 hours before, I go on stage, I play a little, and then I play on stage. I like it very much because I realize after 30 years of my career, this is the best way. But they change it a lot. Now it's the last thing that I mean is this one. Work in the morning, a little, not so much, 2 hours. Then sleeping a little, and 2 hours before the concert, on the stage, just check, but not the performance, just check some passage, and then go back to the concert. Well, in Italy, especially in the beginning of the 9th century, it's coming to be a great school, especially in the south, in Naples, because many professors, they are using a kind of a technique that keep the keyboard in the fingers. So it means that they start to approach the keyboard in a different way. Just, for example, to sing a melody, don't just sing with the power of the hands, but also singing with the power of the finger. It means keeping the keyboard with the fingers muscles before with the arms muscles. And the combination of two movements, it means finger and muscles. You can control this way much more sound, especially if you want to sing in between mezzo forte and pianissimo. You can sing with the same quality of voice because the finger muscles are more smaller and you can control until really pianissimo everything. So it was a kind of school that start from South Italy, and Aldo Ciccolini, he was student of Paolo Denza, and Paolo Denza was student of some student of Franz Liszt. So all the techniques are combined together. If you mix Russian school, French school, Italian school, everything's have some similarity in this. But what is very important, especially for young pianists, is to understand, to feel what's happening in the world. Not just today, but to feel how to do that. So the perfect control of every muscle in the arm, until they relax from here to the finger, and in the same moment, the control of the wrist, flexibility, and the control of the finger, keeping the so there's not exactly talent or something different, because I start my study in Italy, but then I was in France, even if it's professional in Paris. But the culture of piano is now a thing together. And there's not anymore a school. My school came from this tradition, but it's a mix actually with a lot of things. What is important is to feel exactly how to do it. So that's why I insist on doing my lessons with the control of fingers, the control of muscles, the control of sound, because it means to control the sound. That's what I mean.
So when you start to play sound for fingers,
like
practice only fingers and the
place
where you
can hear? Not exactly. I practice all together. I mean yes, all together. I just to have a special attention to listen what's said when I touch the keyboard using my muscular fingers. Using the muscular fingers. And then a special attention when I'm using the computing arm to see. No? So, and the combination of two is very important. So, very, but it's the feeling of listening what's happening. I listen to a lot of young pianists recently, and they play so well. But they didn't listen with their ears. They just repeat the kind of form. But what is very important is to understand what they are doing and listen yourself when you play in some context. Okay?
And then you have recorded so many CDs, and when you record so many CDs, how do you choose the project? Do you recall them in the day, or is it different?
Well, it depends. When I record CD with the orchestra, we are a little bit obliged, like a machine. like a machine. Because the orchestra is not available for me 3 days or 4 days. They are available 1 week. That's all. And so we're recording piano concert in 1 day. Sometimes we're using to record, for example, my recently recording Brahms piano concert No. 1 with the Finland Symphony Orchestra. It was recorded live. That's interesting. What it means live in a recording? It means that you can record general rehearsal and concert. And then make a small editing between two recordings. But when that's an experience, so it's 1 day.
So you mean like, what do you mean by
it means that you can combine first mood from the rehearsal, general rehearsal, and second mood, for example, from the live concert, or something like that. But in any way, without break. So one performance in general rehearsal in the morning, one performance in the night concert. And then you can choose the best movements on each one. For solo recording, it is different. Because you record with you alone, in front of the piano, sometimes in 2 days. Never in 3 days. In 2 days is fine. I work around 5-6 hours each day for recording. It's fine. Well, it depends in which condition, of course. I mean, 5 or 6 hours starting recording. It means all the preparation of the piano, all the preparation of the microphones before starting must be everything perfect. Then I come to the stage and try to play. But from this moment, I have 5 or 6 hours. But of course, there are more because the technician must prepare the things and the piano must be perfectly tuned. I play it, perhaps. I play it. In 2 days.
Thank you.
also a very interesting question. Practicing time, sometimes there's no time, because you fly to another concert and you arrive, you have just 2 hours to rest and then go to the tour. Practicing is a mentality. It depends. It's not the same to practice it's without any interesting vision. I prefer when I have no time, just to do the sport and to remind me all the things about interpretation, the relation of fingers, dynamics, pedal. But just to look in the score when I have no time. And it's quite easy because when you arrive on the stage and you're playing, you remind this kind of thing. This kind of work without piano. But we can work around music also without piano. You can imagine a conductor. Conductor works without orchestra. Right? So also piano is different. They can do that very easily. Open your score and just section by section to remind what you must do. That's practicing without piano. Sometimes you can do it in during the flight, you can do it in a hotel. Okay.
And last but not least, would you speak some words to encourage young musicians or
Of course. First, we need the young musician. I want to say that we need the young musician, young pianist, young artist, because the future of the music is just because them are the new beginning. Classical music is a kind of old style. But the new generation needs to understand what's happening in the past. That's very important. So I say to everybody, try to follow your idea of music, try to follow what's your passion first. Because of course it's so important that when you start music, just don't think about, I want to be a pianist, I want to be a great piano. Just try to understand how much the music is important for your life first. Not only for your career. But I like the young musician, I like the young guys, so I hope to see many, many others, young guys around the world that start to play piano, start to learn music. Because music is one of the best things in life, I think. So why not?
When
you watch, it's my pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.